Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Jagushini and in this video I'm going to do a detailed review of the Boats Air Dopes which I have been using for over just about 3 weeks now. This video will be divided into 5 parts. The first part is unboxing and specifications, where you will be seeing me unboxing the package and you will get to see everything that comes with the package when you place an order for it, and I'm also going to talk about the specifications of the device. The second part will be a detailed yet a concise guide on how to use the device. Now in the third part, I'm going to talk about my personal experience of using the Air Dopes both on an Android device and on an iOS device, so that you know you can make a comparison between them. I mean, I will make a comparison between them to give you a clearer idea. And in this section, I'm also going to talk about the pros, the positive sides of the device. While in the fourth part, I'm going to talk about the negatives of the device, the cons of the device. And finally, in the fifth part, I'm going to give you an overall summary of my experience on the product and my views on it. So, if you want to jump to any one part of the video, like if you do not want to watch the whole video and you're just here to see, okay, what is the negative side of the device, what are the positives of the device, you can skip to that part of the video. I will have all the timestamps down in the description box below, where I will also be linking the product on Amazon from where you can place an order for it, because the retail price of the product is 6,000 rupees, while you almost always get the product at a price of 2499 on Amazon. So please make sure that you check the description box down below. Now before we begin, please hit the subscribe button, and by the end of the video, I hope that you're going to really like it. So don't forget to hit the like button then and leave a comment down below letting me know how you're liking the video. Let's begin. The first segment is unboxing and specifications. Now the Boat Air Dopes, when you order it, comes in a color-coded box, which is great. So basically the box that it comes in is the same as the color that your Air Dopes are. So in my case, I went for the Bumblebee yellow and black. There is a pair of the Air Dopes 441. Then there is the charging case, which is also the case for the Air Dopes, and it also comes with an extra pair of ear caps, and it comes with a charging cable which you can fit into a type C charging port. It comes with an user manual, which is very convenient and really, really nice. And last but not the least, it comes with a year of warranty, which is fantastic. Okay, coming to our second segment, how to use the Boat Air Dopes. Now what you do is you open the magnetic lid of the charging case, and you take both of these ear pods out of the case and put it in your ears, and it just switches on like that. Now you have to find the device that you want to connect to. Now in that device, you switch on the Bluetooth option, and there you will be seeing the Air Dopes 441. You just click on it and it pairs within a few seconds, and that is how you switch it on. Now if a call is coming while you're listening to your music on your phone with the Air Dopes and you want to reject the call because you want to continue watching the video you're watching or listening to the song that you're listening to, then all you need to do is you need to just long touch the Air Dope for 2 seconds and the call is rejected. However, if you want to receive the call, you touch the right Air Dope once, like for a second, and that is how you receive the call. It also comes with a microphone, so it is great, especially if you have to attend webinars, do video calls with your friends, and just, you know, talk generally on the phone. Since it comes with a microphone, it is absolutely amazing, and the microphone, remember, is on both the Air Dopes, like both the left and the right Air Dope. If you want to switch off the earbuds altogether, what you need to do is you need to long press for 5 seconds and the Air Dopes switch off. Remember one thing, if before using it for the first time, you have to make sure that your Air Dopes are 100% charged. Now, how do you know that it is 100% charged? Plug one end of the Type-C cable with the charging case and the other end with a computer or a wall adapter, and you are going to see how much percentage of charge it already has. So if the light here is red, it is 0 to 35% charged. If the light is purple, it is 35 to 75, and if the light is blue, it is 75 to 100. But how you are going to figure out when you are going to charge, when you are going to connect it with your mobile is going to show how many percentage of charge is remaining in your AirDrops. Please remember, while charging the AirDrops, make sure that you keep the lid of the case closed. The LEDs in the AirDrops start flashing in green light. That means that the charge is really falling down and you need to put it on charge. Now coming to the pros of the Boat AirDrop, I personally feel that the first pro is that the AirDrops have type C charging port. Now this is really great because these days most mobile phones also have type C charging port, so you really do not have to look for a separate charger if you want to charge your AirDrops. Now then again, it might be a bit difficult for someone who owns some models of the Apple, the iPhones. But then again, if you really own an iPhone 11, it is unlikely that you are going to use the Boat AirDrops. In fact, I feel that the AirDrops is a tweaked name and a clever play on the Apple AirPods. Yes, so as I was saying, that you do not have to search for a charger. However, the AirDrops, as you already saw, themselves don't come with a charger, but just the charging cable. The second pro is that the charging case is really small, like it literally fits into your palm, and it has a magnetic lid, which is great. The third pro, according to me, is the look of it. Like, it looks great at the price point that it comes in. I love the color variations. If I'm not wrong, it has 4 or 5 color variations. The black and gray looks amazing. The red and black, like my jacket, looks great. The yellow and black that I have looks amazing. So I love the entire look of it. The fourth pro, according to me, is the LED lights on the CTC or the capacitive touch control. I think that's great. Fifth pro, according to me, is that it fits into the ears really well. Now, if it doesn't, like, it does not feel bulky, but if it doesn't fit into your ears well, consider using a different size of ear tips and it might just work perfectly fine. But then again, the extra pair of ear tips that comes with the package, if you order it from Amazon, is of the same size of the, like, of the standard size that the AirDrops already come in, so you might have to purchase it separately if it doesn't fit you well. But then again, I use it and my brother uses it, and in both of our ears it fits really well. My ears are really small and it fits well in that as well. The sixth pro is that there is no crack in full volume, which is amazing. The seventh pro, according to me, which is very important, is that it has great battery backup. I mean, if I charge it in the morning, it lasts me at least till 8 p.m., 9 p.m. in the night. But then again, it is a new product. I have only been using it for 3 weeks, and till now, the battery backup is great. One day I tried to, like, I used it for continuously 6 hours by playing it, playing music non-stop and calling in it, and it ran out of charge after 6 hours. However, I will say this, that my volume wasn't a full 100. If my volume was at full 100, which I did as well, it only lasted me around 4 hours, a bit less than 4 hours. The eighth pro is that the treble is crystal clear, which I find is a great pro. And finally, the ninth pro, that the AirDrops can be used in mono mode, which means that you do not need to put both the AirDrops in your ear, in both your ears, every time you want to use it. Like, if you're just calling and you want to use one AirDrop, you can easily do that and it works perfectly fine. Now coming to the cons. The first con, according to me, is that in low volume, the sound becomes really soft. So you need to keep the volume at least at a 65% to get, like, proper sound with this AirDrops. Now the second con, I don't know if it is just a personal feeling, but since I have an iPhone and my brother has an Android phone and we used it in both, I figured that when I used it with an Android device, the sound seemed much better, louder than when I used it with my iOS device. So I just personally felt it. It might not be true with you, but this was just something that I personally felt. The third con in my experience is that these AirDrops work only if, like, at a maximum of 15 meters distance from your device with which you are using it. But then again, after 15 meters, it starts fading, and by 20, it is completely faded out. So yes, it works only till 15 meters, as long as I have used it. The fourth con is that the air dopes are not great in terms of noise cancellation. Like, you cannot please don't expect 100% noise cancellation. So please do not buy it if your priority is 100% noise cancellation. Now, it has Bluetooth 5.0, but it does not connect to more than one device at a single point of time. So every time you want to pair it with a device, you have to disconnect it from the device it was previously connected to. The sixth con again is, as I said, that it does not come with different sized ear tips. It does come with extra ear tips, but then again, those ear tips are of the same similar standard size. The seventh con is that the sound with the air dopes is very bass heavy. But then again, if you like bass heavy sound, it can be a pro for you. And if you do not, you can always find a fix for it with equalizer settings. The eighth con is that there is no volume control with the air dopes, but then again, you can always control the volume with from your device. So I really don't think that it is much of a con, but yes, I am still going to include it in the cons because some of you might be looking for it, and my intention is to give you an all around best sort of a review on this, so that before you spend your money on it, you get a full view on the whole product. With that being said, let's move on to the fifth and the final segment of this video, which is my overall thoughts on the Boat's AirDope. Okay, so in one sentence, my final thoughts on the Boat's AirDopes is that it is a great value for money product if your budget is within 2500, but it is more suited with Android device than with iOS device. I think it is sturdy, it has great battery backup. If you're not too fussy with your audio quality, then this is a great, great option for you. But if you are someone who is fussy with their audio quality and you are fixed on certain things such as noise cancellation, not bass heavy sound, stuff like that, I would ask you to explore the other options in the market. There are literally way too many, and I also want to try other brands in the future. I also feel that this is a great gifting option to someone you love, especially when you can find it at a great discount on Amazon, like almost throughout the year. I will be having the link of the product in the description box down below, so you can click on it to view the product. And yes, so that was my final review, my thoughts, a very detailed review on the Boat's AirDopes 441. I hope that you liked this video. If you did, please don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, share it with someone you think might find it useful. Don't forget to leave your comment down below in the comment section. I always look forward so much to your comments, and I'll see you very soon in my next video. Bye.